Hello students, good morning. In yesterday's class we completed sales cycle, okay, or what are the different phases of sales cycle. In that we have studied interphase, so different events which occur during interphase. I hope you all have revised that part, because today we are going to study the next phase of the sales cycle, that is a division phase or mitosis. Fine. So in yesterday's class we have seen there are three phases of interphase. Interphase, which is the longest part or the longest phase of sales cycle, it occurs at three stages. There is a G1 phase, there is a S phase and G2 phase. G1 phase, it is also known as post mitotic phase or first gap phase. Fine. During this, cell grows in size. Okay. Cell prepares for the next cell division. So cell organelles are formed, enzymes and proteins which are required for DNA synthesis, these are also formed. Okay. But during S phase, that is a synthetic phase, DNA replication starts. Okay. Each chromosome replicates and forms one more chromosome. That chromatid remain attached to the same centromere. So we have seen that there is a doubling in the DNA amount, or chromatids are doubled but number of chromosomes remain same. Okay, huh? So DNA contain doubles but number of chromosomes remain same. So during S phase, only replication of DNA takes place, DNA synthesis takes place. In G2 phase, which is also known as pre-mitotic phase or second gap phase, remaining synthesis of proteins and enzymes or RNA, which is required for cell division, okay, that is completed. So now cell, it is ready to undergo cell division. I told you there are checkpoints, okay, which check whether each and everything it is properly present in a cell or not. That only cell progresses for the cell division, because cell division, it is a very important event. There should not be any type of mistake should occur. Fine. So when ready it is, when the cell it is fully ready, then it proceeds toward cell division. As I told you, there are two types of cell division. Cell division means what? Whenever parent cell divides into the daughter cell by process, that is known as cell division. There are two types of cell divisions. First one, that is mitosis, and another it is meiosis. Cell divisions. Cell divisions are of two types. First one is known as mitosis, second one is known as meiosis. Okay, two types of divisions. So cell division, today we are going to see in detail mitosis. Fine. So let's begin with the first cell division, that is mitosis. In cell cycle, whichever subphases we have mentioned, that is for mitosis, because mitosis, it is a normal type of cell division which takes place in all somatic cell. Meiosis occurs only at the time of gamete formation or only during reproduction. Fine. So mitosis. Mitosis word came from two words. Mitos meaning thread-like. Mitos meaning thread-like. Okay, and osis meaning state. Okay, it is a thread-like state of chromosome or the genetic material. So that is known as mitosis. Mitosis is also known as equational divisions. Yeah, each and every point which I am telling, it is important. On every point MCQ can frame. So just understand this properly. Mitosis is also known as equational division. Mitosis is also known as equational division. Why equational division? Because ploidy level is maintained. Yesterday I told you what is mean by ploidy level. Ploidy level means number of genomes or the genomic set, chromosomal sets present in an organism. Ploidy level, haploidy, diploidy, number of chromosomal sets. In case of haploid organism, there is only one set of chromosome. In case of diploid organism, there are two sets of chromosome. So number of chromosomal sets present in an individual, it is its ploidy level. So in case of mitosis, ploidy level is maintained. For example, when a diploid cell undergoes mitosis, okay, it forms two cells which are diploid. So ploidy level is maintained.
Fine.
So from diploid cells we get only diploid, from haploid cells we get only haploid. So ploidy level is maintained. Fine. Each parent cell give rise to two daughter cells. So number of for the new cells produced. So each parent cell produces two daughter cells. Okay. Each parent cell produces two daughter cells. Fine. So after every mitotic division, two daughter cells are produced from one parent cell, which are identical. Their ploidy level is same. Fine. So ploidy level is maintained. So mitosis, it is also known as equational division. Okay. Each parent cell produces two daughter cells. Fine. Mitosis was first discovered or first observed by Strasburger in plant cell. Okay. First observed by Strasburger. Okay. In plant cells. Okay. Strasburger first observed mitosis in plant cell in 1875. Whereas in animal cells, mitosis was first observed by Fleming. Fleming only coined the term mitosis. Fine. First observed by Fleming in animal cells. Okay. So in animal cell, it was first observed by Fleming in year 1879. Okay. And the term mitosis was given by Fleming in 1882. Term given by Fleming in 1882. So mitosis occurs in all types of cell, whether it is animal, whether it is plant, in normal cells, normal body cell. Mitosis is essential. The significance of mitosis, it is responsible for growth. It is required for repairism. It is responsible for overall development. So whenever there is a growth in plant, it is due to addition of cells. So that addition of cell, it is because of mitotic cell division. So for general growth and development, mitosis is an essential division. Meiosis results in haploid cells. Okay? So meiosis takes place only at the time of gamete formation. Okay? Rest of the time for growth, for multiplication, for repair, there is a mitotic cell division. So it takes place in all body cells. We call them as somatic cells. Okay? So occur in, so mitosis occurs in somatic cells. Okay, somatic cells means which were normal body cells. So we can say non-reproductive cells. Somatic cells mean normal body cells or non-reproductive cells. Non-reproductive cells as well as in reproductive cells. Okay, mitosis takes place in reproductive cell also, but not for the formation of gamete. This is for the multiplication of gamete mother cells. Okay, as well as in reproductive cells, as well as in reproductive cells for multiplication of mother cells. It could be a sperm mother cells or egg mother, that is oogonia and spermatogonia. That is oogonia and spermatogonia. Okay. So if question will come, which is a common type of cell division for non-reproductive as well as reproductive cells. So that is your mitosis. Meiosis takes place only in reproductive cells. Fine. So mitosis occurs in somatic cell. It is responsible for growth as well as repairism. So overall growth as well as development, repair. It is because of this your mitotic cell division. Mitosis occurs in non-reproductive cells also, but there it is responsible for multiplication of spermatogonia and oogonia. The actual haploid cells are formed because of meiosis. Fine. In your previous standards, you might have learned these terms, mitosis, meiosis, but what actually mean of mitosis? So mitosis, it is an equational division. It maintains the ploidy level. See, it is very easy to understand. Whenever any part of our body gets damaged, yes, soon it is replaced by a similar type of cell. That every cell should receive same type of genetic information, because it is going to form the part of that damaged part. So all cells which are formed after mitotic division, they are clones of their parent. They receive identical genes. There is no recombination, no exchange of genes. So this point also will mention here. No recombination, no genetic recombination, no genetic recombinations. So there are no variations. We know that for sexual reproduction, or sexual reproduction brings variation. At the time of sexual reproduction, meiosis, when it takes place in the reproductive cell, it involves a crossing over that we'll see after our genes get exchanged. So new genes or the new genetic combinations are produced that could lead to variation. And because of this, progeny is not similar like their parents. Okay, or we are not exact copies of our parent. We share some genes from mother and father, but we are not exact copies of our parent, because at the time of meiosis, genetic exchange takes place, okay, that is known as recombination. During mitosis, recombination does not take place. So newly formed cells or progenies are clones, or they are identical among themselves as well as with their parents. Means newly formed cells, we call them as daughter cells. His daughter cells have similar type of genes, okay, as well as they are similar with their parents. Fine. So they are called as clones of each other. Fine. So these are some general things about mitosis. So there is no recombination. So variations are not brought by mitotic cell division. Mitosis occurs at four stages. Yeah? Now what we have to think? Now cell has completed the G2 phase, and now cell is ready to begin the mitosis. Fine. I told you, if we take example of human cell where it completes the cell cycle within 24 hours, from that 23 hours there is an interphase. For last 1 to 2 hours there is a mitosis. So these mitosis have 4 stages. Okay. Or initially it involves 2 events. There is a karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Fine. So mitosis. Okay. Mitosis involves 2 events. First one, karyokinesis. Karyokinesis. And second one, cytokinesis. Okay, there is a karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Karyokinesis means nuclear division. First there is a division of DNA, okay, and then there is a division or separation of parent cell into 2 daughter cells. So karyokinesis means karyon, meaning nucleus. This is a division of nucleus. Okay, whereas cytokinesis means division of cytoplasm. Okay, parent cytoplasm, it is equally divided into 2 daughter cells, and then 2 daughter cells get separated from each other. So that is known as cytokinesis. So first there is a karyokinesis, nuclear material, it is equally distributed in 2 daughter cells, and then cytoplasm, it is equally distributed. So first there is a karyokinesis, and then there is a cytokinesis, fine? Karyokinesis involves four stages. Now let's see which are those. First one, prophase. Fine. The first phase of mitosis, that is known as prophase. The second one, it is known as metaphase. First is prophase, second one is metaphase, third one it is anaphase, and fourth one it is telophase. Okay, I will explain these four stages first. Later on, either I will send snaps of notes or I will write down these notes later on. First, try to understand. Along with this, I will send the video also or some images. So that, because this is a process, okay, huh? And to see the process, at least at certain stages, we have to study, then only we will understand. This is a cyclic event, fine. Now to study these stages, generally we use onion root tip. In your previous standards, you might have heard this. Now, which types of cells? Now, these are some general things related to this. Which plant part or which part we can study if we want to see the stages of mitosis? As I told you, mitosis takes place in normal body cells, so obviously flower we will not use, okay, or reproductive androecium or gynoecium we will not use. So the best material to study stages of mitosis, that is root tips, because we know that in case of plants, these plants can grow indefinitely because of meristematic cells. These meristematic cells have ability of cell division. What type of cell division? Mitosis. Fine. First lesson, growth. Growth in case of plant, it is, yes, it is indeterminate. Okay. Plants can grow till their life, or they can grow for their whole life. Okay, because of apical meristem, okay, which is located at shoot apex and root apex. These meristematic cells, they have ability of cell division. Okay, huh? Just try to understand this. So, which type of cell division it is? This is mitosis. Mitosis adds new cells. So, obviously, it results into multiplication. It results into growth. Yes. So, mitosis takes place in the apical meristem. The best part to study, that is a root tip. So, generally, generally we use onion root tip. Fine. So after this, I'll give you idea of that experiment also, because in 12th class you have to perform that experiments. Mitosis also you are going to perform. Fine. So for that you should know what are the stages and all everything. So for that we use onion root tips. Fine. So the technique methodology afterward I will tell you. So as it is a cyclic process, at certain stages, based on the events, we made four subphases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. What is happening throughout this process? The DNA, which is duplicated during interphase, cytoplasm is also increased, cell organelles are also increased. Okay, huh? Number of chromosomes are same, but DNA content is doubled. Now, this is equally distributed in two daughter cells. Fine. So, now before prophase, what is the state of nucleus? Yes, huh? Just try to recall all these things, try to think what is the condition of nucleus just before the beginning of cell division. Now, what is the condition? Each centromere or condensation of DNA has begun. I told you that in interphase or G1 phase, the DNA, it is in a thread form. But as it progresses towards cell division or metaphase, condensation of DNA begins. Because if the DNA is present in a thread form, it could break at the time of cell division. So for that, DNA condenses, okay, they become chromosomes. Okay, so just before the prophase, condensation of chromatids has begun. Okay, condensation has started. Okay, chromosomes condense, so they appear very thick. Now the chromatin, which appear thread like during interphase, start appearing much thicker at the beginning of prophase because condensation has begun. Fine here. So in prophase, some events occur. So major events which occur during prophase. First one, that is condensation of chromosome. Condensation of chromosome. And we find that each chromosome is attached to two coiled chromatids. Fine. One was original, one was another copy or the replicated copy. Both remain attached to same centromere, sister chromatids. Fine. So in prophase, what happened? In prophase, condensation of chromatin begins. First event. Try to understand this. In prophase, what happened? Condensation of chromatin begins. The chromatin, which was thread-like during interphase, start condensing. With whom? Along with histone proteins and at higher level with non-histone proteins. Fine. So condensation of chromatin has begun. Now each chromosome appears to have two sister chromatids. Okay, or it is a highly coiled chromatin remain attached to the same centromere. Fine. Two important events of prophase. First one, condensation of chromatin. Okay. By the end of prophase, we find that each chromosome or each centromere is attached to two highly coiled chromatids. End are not still visible at the early prophase, but at end or at the late prophase, just before to the metaphase, when these two chromatids or sister chromatids just get separated from each other little bit, we can find their ends also. Third event happen is what? There is a disappearance of nuclear membrane and nucleolus. Yeah, what is happening? Disappearance of nuclear membrane and nucleolus. Why? Because for separation of chromosome, we need more space. Nucleus, inside the nucleus, chromosomes will not accommodate properly. So, and right now there is no role of nucleus as well as nucleolus also. Right now, what is the major task? Just the division of genetic material. DNA has to be divided. Chromosomes have to be equally distributed among two daughter cells. So, fine. For that, more space is required. So, nuclear membranes start disappearing. It completely disappeared by the end of prophase. Fine. So, in prophase, nuclear membrane start disappearing. Fine. Nucleolus also start disappearing. See here now. Now I am drawing some diagrams. Fine. Suppose this is our cell. Okay. Before cell division, this is the nucleus. Inside this nucleus, there is a chromatin, nucleolus, cytoplasm and all everything. Now when cell progresses or when it proceeds toward prophase, then what happens? When cell enters in prophase, nuclear membrane start disappearing. Okay, by the end of prophase, it is completely disappeared. Nucleolus also start disintegrating. There is no need of nucleolus. Fine. And condensation of chromatin begins. And now they look like a thread like this. So condensation, they are not highly condensed. Still they are longer thread like. Okay? But condensation begin. That is known as prophase. Fine. Condensation of chromatin begin. Okay. Each centromere shows presence of two highly coiled sister chromatids. Fine. So the stage, it looks like a thread. Okay. That is known as prophase. Fine. So by the end of prophase, what happened? Nuclear membrane and nucleolus completely disappeared. Okay. Chromosomes are condensed. Fine. When cell enters in the metaphase, chromosomes take their full shape. I told you, if we want to study the morphology of chromosome, metaphase is the stage where we can study their shape, position of centromere, size, everything. Because in metaphase, chromosomes take their exact shape, they are fully condensed. in anaphase, they will break in between. So when we want to study any type of chromosomal aberration, when we want to prepare the karyotypy, diagram, in all the cases, we have to take the image or photograph of a cell at metaphase. For MCQ, this question can come. At metaphase, chromosomes have their exact shape. So when cell progresses in metaphase, okay, now here nuclear membrane or nucleolus, it is completely disappeared. Okay, now there are chromosomes only. Fine. We will take example. Suppose in a cell there are four chromosomes, means there are two pairs of chromosomes. Okay, I will draw that by different colored pen. Okay, chromosomes are fully condensed. Okay, fine. Chromosomes are fully condensed and each centromere is attached. Each centromere, it is attached to the two highly coiled chromatids. Fine. So in metaphase, what is the condition? In metaphase, now chromosomes are at their full shape. Now let's see which events occur during metaphase. Fine. Now during metaphase, what is happening? Now the first event which occur during this stage is that chromosome get aligned on the imaginary axis of a cell, that is known as metaphase plate. All the chromosomes, suppose in a cell there are four chromosomes, so all these four chromosomes, they get arranged on the equator of a cell, that is known as metaphase plane. It is an imaginary line on the equator. On this line, all these chromosomes get arranged. Okay, so this is known as metaphase plate. Okay, this imaginary plane on which all the chromosomes arrange, okay, that is known as metaphase plate. Fine, understood the first event. After this, what is happening? Spindle fibers attached to the centromere. Next event, very important. Spindle fiber attaches to centromere. Why? What is the significance of this? In case of animal cell, there are centrioles. Fine. So there are two centrioles which lie just outside of this nucleus. So in prophase, what happened? In prophase, the centrioles also, they move toward opposite side. As I told, there are two centrioles. Fine. Centrioles also replicate during interphase. Fine. So from that, one centriole containing two centrosomes move toward opposite side. So by the end of prophase, one centriole, okay, so both these centrioles, they go to the opposite side. In case of plant cells, centrioles are not present. Okay, the spindle fibers, which are composed of microtubules, fine. Microtubules are also synthesized during S phase, that already we have seen. So spindle fibers are formed in case of animal cells from centrioles. Okay, so these spindle fibers, they go and attach to the centromere. Do you remember where they exactly attach? They attach to the kinetochore. We have studied the structure of chromosome. In chromosome, just outside to the centromere, there are proteinaceous discs. That is known as kinetochore. Fine. So this kinetochore, it is a site of attachment of your spindle fibers. Fine. Actually, the position of chromosomes, it is horizontal. So they lie horizontally. Okay. I'll show two chromosomes only. Like this, they arrange. Now these are the spindle fibers which have come from two opposite pole. Spindle fiber from this side would attach to the kinetochore of this side, okay, whereas spindle fiber from this pole would attach to kinetochore of this side. find. So these are spindle fibers. Spindle fibers. So spindle fibers will originate from opposite poles, and these spindle fibers would go and attach to the kinetochore of centromere. Fine. There are some spindle fibers which run continuously from one pole to the another pole. Means they do not attach to the centromere. So they are known as continuous spindle fibers. Okay. Whereas those spindle fibers which attach to the kinetochore or centromere, they are known as discontinuous spindle fibers. Notes I will provide you in the written form. So no need to worry about this. Just try to understand this. Huh? What is happening during metaphase? During metaphase, all the chromosomes attain their full shape. All chromosomes get line or the equator. That is known as metaphase split. After that, what happens? Spindle fibers form. The spindle fibers are made up of tubulin, fine. This spindle fiber attaches to the centromere, where just outside the centromere there is a kinetochore. So spindle fiber attaches to the kinetochore from this pole to this side, from this pole to this side. There are some spindle fiber which runs from one pole to the another pole. These are known as continuous type of spindle fibers. Okay, they are not involved in the condensation or separation of chromosomes. Fine. After this, now what happened? Now all the chromosomes are arranged on equatorial plane. Spindle fibers are attached to the centromere. Fine. Now one additional point I am going to tell you here is that there are some mitotic poisons. Or there are some chemicals which are commonly called as mitotic poison. Okay, mitotic poisons. Okay, like colchicine. Like colchicine. Fine. These colchicine or these chemicals, they prevent formation of spindle fibers. Fine. Because of this, what happened? Chromosomes will not separate. And one cell would receive, or the daughter cell which is formed, in that ploidy level doubles. Okay, there is a significance also. Means diploid cell become tetraploid. How? We will see later. Right now, just remember what is mean by mitotic poison. Let first complete the process. Once you understood how mitosis takes place, then slowly I will add these things. Huh? Mitotic poison colchicine in interferes with the spindle fiber formation. Okay, that results into increased ploidy level. Fine. So at metaphase, now spindle fibers are attached. Now during anaphase, what happened? During anaphase, centromere splits in between because of condensation of spindle fibers. These spindle fibers, which are now attached to the centromere, they just condense or they contract, thus breaking the centromere in between. Fine. They break the centromere in between and they pull these chromatid toward one side. Yeah? Mitosis, it is a most dramatic phase. I told you, lot of events occur. It is just like a drama. A lot of things are happening in a cell. When you will watch the video, I'll send you one video for mitosis. Fine. Huh? Inside a living cell. That time you see, within a fraction of a second or within some time only, so many things are happening in a cell. Now what we have to do here, with or which things you have to coordinate. DNA content has doubled. Fine. Chromosome numbers are same. Usually in a cell we get only one chromatid. Now each chromosome has two chromatids. Means we have to separate these two chromatids from each other. So for that, splitting of centromere it is required. So splitting of centromere takes place during anaphase. Fine. So when cell progresses in anaphase, that time what happens? The spindle fibers start contracting. Spindle fibers contract. Because of this, centromere splits. It is cut horizontally. Now, the spindle fibers continue to contract. Because of this, what happens? Suppose now this centriole or this centromere has cut in between. And now this will contract. Then this chromatid will move toward this pole. This chromatid will go toward this pole. Fine. So there is a movement of sister chromatids toward opposite poles. So now here one chromatid will move this side, another chromatid will move toward this side. Because of what? Because of condensation of condensation of spindle fibers. These spindle fibers will condense. And now sister chromatids will separate from each other due to splitting of centromere. So if you observe the slided anaphase, you find there are two bunches of banana on both these poles. Now what happened? Sister chromatids got separated from each other, and on one side one copy of chromatid has gone. Again, DNA content was double, chromosome numbers were same. So here also on both the sides number of chromosomes are two. Only the thing is that there is only one chromatid attached to it. The additional copy of chromatid, the sister chromatid which was formed at the time of interphase, now it got separated. So at two poles, we get similar number of chromosome, with one chromatid attached to each centromere. Still ploidy, it is same. So this takes place during anaphase. So anaphase, it is a phase where due to condensation or due to contraction of spindle fibers, centromere splits. Sister chromatids get pulled toward opposite pole. Now in case of metaphase, I told you either spindle fibers could form from centrioles. There are asters, so that is known as astral type of cell division. Astral and unastral. Unastral means when there are no spindle fibers, like in case of plant cell, that is known as unastral type. So cell divisions could be of astral type or amphiastral and unastral. Astral or amphiastral in animals, and unastral in plant, because there are no centrioles. During anaphase, what is happening? There is a condensation or contraction of spindle fibers that result into breakage of centromere, and that separates two sister chromatids. Further, spindle fibers continue to contract. It brings sister chromatids to opposite pole. Now physically DNA material has separated from each other, but still it is in the chromatin form. Still it is in the chromosome form. So the last step, that is telophase, it is exactly reverse like prophase. Now see here what happened. Nuclear material got separated. So karyokinesis has completed. Nuclear material, DNA, chromosomes are separated from each other. Now in telophase, what happened? I'll show in this only figure. Now the two sets of chromosomes which are brought to opposite pole, they undergo decondensation, because again chromosomes have to take the shape of chromatin, because chromatin, it is an active form of DNA. So there is decondensation of chromosome. Chromosome again decondense. Nucleolus reappear. Nuclear membrane also reappears. Exact reverse. Those events which occur during prophase, same events are occurring during telophase, but in a reverse manner. So first there is a decondensation of chromosome, nucleolus and nuclear membrane reappears, and then it is followed by cytokinesis. Now cytoplasm is separated. So then it is followed by cytokinesis, and then two daughter cells are produced. The process of cytokinesis is different in plant cell and animal cells. In case of plant cell, there is a cell plate formation. As in case of plant cell, there are cell wall. I told you, in case of plant cell, cell division or cytokinesis is bigger from central part toward the periphery. So at the time of cytokinesis, what happened? The middle lamella, calcium, magnesium, pectate, Golgi complex, they establish at the middle part, and then that extends toward periphery, so primary wall. Yes, sir. So this type of cytokinesis occur in plant, okay? From center toward periphery, okay? Cytokinesis, or this type of cytokinesis centripetal, okay? That is observed in case of plant cells. Fine. So in case of plant cells, cytokinesis begins from center and then it progresses toward periphery. So calcium, magnesium pectate, okay, phragmoplast, I told you there is a filaments of ACR, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, they aggregate over here. Cell plate it is formed, and then two cells are separated. Now these two cells which are formed, okay, that is known as dyad. Okay, dyad meaning a group of two cells. Fine. Dyad meaning what? Dyad meaning group of two cells. So two daughter cells are formed. Newly formed cell. Yesterday we started our cell cycle with newly formed cells. So after telophase, once cytokinesis is completed, two new cells are formed. In case of animals, what happened? In case of animal cell, there is a furrow formation, means as there is no cell wall in case of animal cell. So cell membrane invaginates inside, so it is from peripheral to inside. This furrow, it progresses ahead or it moves ahead and it comes till center and then separates the two cells. So just pinching, as we have seen in case of endocytosis, exocytosis, so this membrane invaginates, both these grooves or both these invaginations, they meet, okay, and then it is separated. So the cytokinesis in plants, it is different. Cytokinesis in animal cells, it is also different. One, it is centripetal, another is the centrifugal. Fine. So in this way, mitosis result into equational it maintains the ploidy level. Okay, number of chromosomes are same. We started with two chromosomes. Okay, here also at the end we got the two chromosomes. Fine. So chromosome number remains same. Already the replicated chromatid which is attached to the centromere, it is separated. Fine. Your meiosis, it depends on mitosis. So if you have understood events of mitosis, then only you can understand events of meiosis. Remember this. Fine. Although this lesson is very short, but it is very important lesson. Fine. So these are the four stages of mitosis: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Along with this, I will send you one video. I will send you images, actual images which I have taken while performing the experiment, okay, on onion root tip. As I told you, next year you will also perform the experiment. Fine. So how a cell exactly looks, or how these chromosomes look exactly during cell division. Fine. So this is the mitosis notes I will send you. You can just note down this, but try to understand how mitosis takes place. During mitosis, there is a splitting of centromere. Centromere splits. When we learn, or when we will study the differences in mitosis and meiosis, that time again we are going to study, or we will take these events, means what is happening during mitosis which is not happening during meiosis. So during mitosis there is a division of centromere. Why division of centromere? Because each centromere has two chromatids, and these two chromatids have to be distributed in two daughter cells. So centromere split. DNA content has double, number of chromosomes are same. So chromosomes are aligned horizontally on equator. All the chromosomes, not in pairs. If in a human cell there are 46 chromosomes, all 46 chromosomes, they arrange on equator. Centromere splits in between. When the spindle fiber, they contract, sister chromatids are pulled toward opposite pole. Okay? And again, nuclear membrane is formed. Nucleolus reappear, and this chromosome decondense, okay, and again form chromatin. From there, G1 phase begin. Again, now cell prepares for the next cell division. So first it will grow in size, and then that cell will start preparing itself for the next cell division. Fine. So in this way, mitosis occurs in cell, whether plant cell or animal cell. Only difference in case of the cytokinesis. In case of plant cell, cytokinesis takes place from central toward the periphery. In case of animal cell, it is from periphery toward the mid part. Okay, so this is for the day. Today we have completed the process of mitosis, phases, all phases of mitosis. In tomorrow's class, we will see what are the modifications of this mitosis, as well as I told you that there are some checkpoints which regulate the overall process of cell division. So that part we will complete first, and then we will move toward the meiotic cell division. Fine, you revise this part, and now we will meet in the next lecture. Thank you.